Quite some time back, while discussing the async task, I had said that
there is another way of stopping the async task, that is my async task dot cancel. You can pass on a boolean variable true and you will still get the same behavior.
There was a mistake on my part that I had not explained the usage of cancel method correctly. Thanks to one of the subscribers who had corrected me, I want to clarify that now. Proper way of using the cancel method in the async task is when you invoke asyncTask.cancel, this particular method on post execute would not get called. Instead of that, there is another method called as onCancelled. That is the method that gets called. There is a method called as isCancelled, which you can use inside the doInBackground method to check whether the async task has been cancelled. So what you can do is, inside the doInBackground method, you can check whether isCancelled is returning true or false, and if it is returning true, you can simply break the loop. And this is one way of making sure that the async task gets cancelled immediately. If at all you want to update the UI on cancellation, you can do that. Otherwise, there is no need to do anything here, and the async task would still work in the same fashion. So just to demonstrate that, let me run this. The async task started. Counter is being updated using the onProgressUpdate method. That is this part. And then when I invoke the stop sync, it actually invokes doInBackground inside onCancelled, and this returns true, and that is why the loop gets broken, and that is how the async task stops. So this is a correction I wanted to emphasize to the audience. I will be coming back with the regular video. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.